Sir, my equipment and personal effects have been stowed in full accordance with Transport Code Section 2. If I may say so again, sir, it is truly an honor to be selected for Havoc Squad.
Clearly our first assignment should be a welcome party.
I appreciate the sentiment, but I have a great deal of intelligence to catch up on. I intend to begin reviewing and memorizing all relevant dossiers and intelligence reports on our assignment immediately. If I discover any points of confusion or areas where I believe I can contribute, I'll submit a full 587B report.
Carry on, Dorne.
Yes, sir. Excuse me, sir. May I have a moment of your time?
I've always got time for you, Alara.
Thank you, sir. As a condition of my service in the Republic military, Personnel Division requires that I report regularly on my activities. However, my Havoc Squad missions are classified and cannot be shared with Personnel Division. I'd like to ask if you would vouch for me when I report in.
I'll be happy to help.
Thank you very much, sir. We should use the ship's secure line. Captain Kaelor, this is Alara Dorne, personnel number 22795, reporting in per Regulation 449.
Please, Alara, you don't have to give me the full rundown every time. I know who you are. How are things?
Well enough, sir. Allow me to introduce you to the commander of Havoc Squad, my new CO. Sir, this is Captain Kaelor, Army Personnel Division.
Good to meet you, Captain.
The pleasure's mine. Meeting you is a real honor. Tell me about being in the top squad in the Republic, Alara. You must be keeping very busy.
I'm sorry, Captain, but you aren't authorized to know about Havoc Squad's activities. My CO will have to vouch for me from now on.
What? Alara, I don't want to be a hard case, but rules are rules. This top secret junk won't fly.
All Havoc Squad activities are highly classified, Captain. I'm sorry for any inconvenience.
Inconvenience. Just carry on, Alara. We'll talk about this after I've had a word with my superiors. Kaelor out.
I wasn't expecting him to react so strongly. Surely he didn't expect me to report on classified information.
Protecting classified information is a top priority.
Yes, sir. I'm surprised the captain didn't agree. If you'll excuse me, sir, I have several matters to attend to. Thank you for your time. Sir, I feel I owe you an apology. After we spoke with Captain Kaelor, I was unnecessarily curt with you. You've been very supportive. That hasn't always been the case with Republic personnel I've dealt with since defecting.
It must be hard to work with people who don't trust you.
I expected some degree of reservation, but nothing like what I've actually encountered. People distrust me as soon as I speak. They only hear my accent. Even when I'm not a potential spy, I'm a resource. Endless questions about Imperial culture, personnel, military procedures. It's exhausting.
You're a good soldier, Dorne. Don't worry about what other people expect.
Thank you, sir. I really don't complain by nature. Mistrust and inconvenience are a small price to pay for a clear conscience. I don't regret defecting to the Republic at all. Despite my past, I was allowed to join the military, earn commendations and serve in the Republic's most elite squad. I'm very fortunate.
The Republic is lucky to have you.
Thank you. I'm very proud to be here. Sir, I wondered if I might ask a personal question about the former Havoc Squad member's defection. What was it like to have your commander and comrades join the enemy? How did you feel?
It was hard to see such great soldiers throwing away everything they'd fought for.
I can only imagine what it must have been like. I've always wondered how my family took the news of my defection. It must have been difficult for them to understand.
Your family is still in the Empire?
Oh yes. The Dornes are very proud of their history within the Empire. Members of the Dorne family have served with distinction in the Imperial military for generations. It's an important family tradition. It isn't easy to reach prominence in the Empire with no aptitude for the Force, but my family did it. I hope they're all still well.
It can't be easy to fight against your family's side.
It is a consequence I accepted when I chose to defect. I don't give it a second thought. If I may say so, sir, you've had quite an impressive career. You're the commander of the most elite squad in the entire Republic. You must be quite proud.
I just go where they tell me and do my job. Nothing more.
Clearly, you do more than that. or you wouldn't have such an exceptional service record. I remember when I first enlisted and qualified for medical specialization. My brother Alexei completed his technical specialization on the same day. We were both proud to finally serve in the Imperial military. My brother advanced quickly, but I became disillusioned as time went on.
Why did you become disillusioned?
The Imperial military was supposed to stand for honor and discipline. But my superiors discarded those concepts any time a Sith asked it. I'd always been taught that the Jedi and the Republic were genocidal hypocrites. But the only brutalities I witnessed were committed by my own comrades.
I'm sure it wasn't easy to learn the truth like that.
I have always preferred difficult truths to easy lies. I raised my concerns with my superiors, but they only questioned my resolve. Soon, I would have been forced to prove my loyalty by carrying out orders directly against my conscience. I chose to defect instead.
I'd say you made the right move, Dorne.
Once I'd made the decision, I slipped away during my squad's next night patrol. I was gone before anyone realized it. I surrendered to the first Republic patrol I came across and declared my intention to defect. That was over 3 years ago. It's strange to realize how long it's been. The Republic truly feels like my home now. Sir, I need to speak to you immediately. I've received a strange holomessage that appears to bear Imperial signal codes. I haven't watched it yet. I wanted you present to supervise and confirm that I'm not engaged in secret communications with Imperial personnel.
We better watch it immediately.
Yes, sir. I'll load it now.
Hey, Laura. It's me, Alexei. I hope you're well. It's been a long time.
Alexei? Sir, this message is from my brother. I don't know what to say.
I know this must be hard for you.
It's more surprising than anything. I honestly never thought I'd see his face again.
I'm sorry to contact you like this, but I need your help. My men and I, we're as good as dead. We're on Nar Shaddaa. We were caught tampering with one of the Hutt's operations. We never dreamed the slugs would have so much security. These Hutts are Imperial allies, Alara. There is no rescue team. We'll be disavowed and left to die. Please. You're my only hope now.
Get your brother out of there, Alara. You've got my leave.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate your willingness to help, given the circumstances. I believe I can bring him to our side. I know my brother better than anyone. I can convince him to defect. Perhaps it's best if I see to this matter alone, sir. Alexei will be much easier to convince if he doesn't feel outnumbered.
If you can bring him in willingly, then all the better.
Coordinates are included at the end of the message. I'll prep my gear for search and rescue. The operation was a complete success, sir. Per code 23 of the enemy interaction guidelines, Alexei officially defected to the Galactic Republic. Given the circumstances, we didn't have much time to catch up, but I have my brother back. Thank you for allowing me to help him.
I'm happy to hear that everything worked out.
Hopefully Personnel Division will allow me to stay in contact with Alexei, not privately, of course, and help guide him through the defection process. I should start compiling notes for him. Thanks again, sir. Sir, I'm sorry to bother you, but I've received a troubling message from Captain Kalor, my supervisory officer from Personnel Division. He ordered me to contact him immediately. I hoped you could join me for the conversation.
I'd be glad to.
Thank you very much, sir. I'll raise him on the holo now. Captain Kalor, this is Alara Dorne, personnel number 22795, reporting in per your request.
Always the whole mess, every time. Anyway, yes, thank you for returning my call, Alara. It's about this whole situation with your brother. You did a great job, obviously, but people are starting to think you have more information than you're sharing.
If Alara has any more intel for you, she'll share it.
Alara, if you have information you'd like to share, I think this would be a good time for you to come in.
I appreciate the offer, but I have no further information of value to you.
Suit yourself. I have work to do. Kalor out.
He's still demanding more. After everything I've done, what do I have to do to prove myself?
You're a good soldier, Alara. You've got nothing to prove.
Thank you, sir. But I think it's clear that some people don't feel the same way. Let's just get back to work. I'd rather focus on something else for a while. Sir, I need your approval to requisition some supplies for my medical kit. I've categorized the items by relative priority. Everything fits within our allotment under supply code 18, but items near the bottom of the list can wait if necessary.
Best to make sure you can still patch up my handsome face.
Yes, sir. I'd say your features are worthy of preservation.
Was that... were you just flirting with me?
I see no reason I shouldn't be free to flirt if you do. Provided it doesn't interfere with operational effectiveness, of course, sir. I'm still quite concerned about Captain Kalor and his accusations, sir. If Personnel Division thinks I'm withholding information about the Empire, they can continue hounding me under Security Regulation 15. I think if men like Kalor had their way, I'd be locked in a room reciting the minutiae of Imperial culture until the end of time.
I won't let them do that to you, Alara.
Thank you. I truly appreciate everything you do for me. I do sometimes wonder if I'm being unfair, though. I'm one of the only people in the Republic with extensive knowledge of Imperial culture. Perhaps I have a responsibility to do what few others can, even if it's not what I'd like to be doing.
You shouldn't be forced to do anything.
I'm glad I'm not the only one who feels that way. Thank you for taking the time to hear me out. It's good to have someone to talk to.
I know I'm your commander, but that doesn't have to be all.
I hadn't... That isn't something I'm used to considering. I really shouldn't occupy any more of your time. Thank you, sir. Could I speak with you privately for a moment? I just need you to know, sir, that I've become quite fond of you. You've helped me far more than anyone I've ever known. Because of this, I'm forced to ask if perhaps you might feel the same fondness for me?
I think you're an amazing woman, Alara.
I'm just... Personnel Code Section 2 discourages romantic relationships between personnel, particularly commanding officers. I want to spend more time with you, but I don't want to negatively affect squad performance.
We're both mature adults, Alara. I'm sure we can stay professional.
Our service records would suggest that we're fully capable of navigating complex situations. Personnel Code Section 1 encourages personnel to spend time together socially. Correlations between interpersonal compatibility and unit performance are strongly positive. We should probably return to our duties, but I think this is the right choice. Sir, if you think you could spare a moment. I'd just like you to know how happy I've been. Are you happy?
I enjoy every second we're together, Alara.
So do I. I haven't taken the time for personal relationships since I came to the Republic. Not until now. When I'm with you, I don't have to be the defector or the intelligence asset. I can just be me.
I imagine you've had to prove yourself a lot over the years.
I have. It's exhausting. In any case, you've been wonderful, and I just thought it would be good to let you know. I'll let you get back to work. We've been through quite a bit, haven't we, sir? Since I joined Havoc Squad, I've seen more combat and performed more medical treatments than in my entire career beforehand. I've learned a great deal.
And there's still plenty of work for Havoc to do.
Yes, sir. Plenty of opportunities to improve my skills even further. I couldn't be prouder to be a part of Havoc Squad. I'm serving the Republic and becoming a better soldier and medic every day. And I have you to thank for it all. Most officers would never have given me this chance, but you did. Thank you.
I just picked you for your looks. The skills are a bonus.
Perhaps I only took the position because of your looks. Enough talk. Let's put some of this experience to work, shall we? Sir, there is a very important matter that requires your immediate attention. I've noted numerous reports and personnel documents that the other members of the squad have failed to keep up to date. I've collected the files into datapads. I suggest that the others take them off ship to fill out. A change of scenery helps when completing reports, I think.
Sounds like we'll have the whole ship to ourselves.
Yes, I suppose that's true, isn't it? Please excuse me a moment, sir. So, based on past performance when filing reports, Jorgen will complete his tasks the fastest. I've estimated at least 73 minutes. Do you think we could find a productive way to spend the time before us, sir?
Let's get straight to work.
Gladly. I suppose it's wrong to hope that the rest of the squad gets behind on their reports again soon. Is it time to get back to work?
Dorn! Bless it, where are you?
I think our time is up for now. This was fantastic. Let's not wait too long for next time. Sir, I was wondering if you've received any messages from Captain Kalor recently. I've not heard anything since the situation with Raidu. I'm a bit concerned, to be honest.
The less we hear from Kalor, the better.
It's been nice to take my mind off his accusations, but I doubt he's given up yet. I attempted to contact him for my standard activity report, but I was told that he's out of the office on an important assignment. I can't help but wonder if I'm a part of that assignment. I don't look forward to finding out.
Whatever Kalor does, we'll deal with it.
We have enough to deal with as it is. I shouldn't be thinking about problems that may not exist. Sorry to trouble you, sir. Let's just get back to work. I need to get something off my chest. Our work is quite dangerous. And of course, the future is always uncertain.
You sound upset. What is it?
I'm not upset. That isn't it at all. I love you. We risk our lives every day. And I couldn't let another moment pass without telling you how much I love you.
I love you too, Alara.
I can't tell you how much it means to hear you say it too. I got something for us. It took a great deal of research and quite a few holocalls to some very important people. Form 3578K officially authorizes us to pursue a mutual romantic relationship. I was hoping we could sign it together.
I'm happy to make it official.
Fantastic! Now then, since that's out of the way, I was thinking... That is, if you have the time.
Just try and stop me.
I wouldn't dream of it. My. So many reasons to love you. It's hard to pick. Let's go face the galaxy together. Sir, I'm afraid I need to request a brief leave of absence. It's Kalor. He's attempting to exploit a loophole in Investigative Appeals Process Subsection 4 in order to reopen his inquiry without new cause.
I think it's time to introduce that scumbag to the roomier end of an airlock.
That won't be necessary. I'm not going to give Kalor the time to carry his supposed investigation any further. I'm going to Coruscant. I have every message, every report, every call recorded. It's time to demonstrate to Kalor's superiors exactly what his supposed service to the Republic has accomplished.
I'll come with you. With my word backing you up, you can't fail.
You're very kind to offer, sir, but I need to handle this myself. Bringing a war hero along would seem like a diversionary tactic. I'll return as quickly as possible. Sir, I am ordered to report that I, Alara Dorn, personnel number 22795, am no longer classified as a person of concern. The personnel division of the Army of the Galactic Republic has declared that I am to be treated as a fully protected legal citizen, effective immediately.
This is great news, Alara. I'm really happy for you.
I couldn't have done it without all of your support. Kalor never saw it coming. When I exercised my right under Service Code 1 to an immediate personnel hearing, he was literally speechless. I demonstrated documentation for every moment of his pointless investigation. Once the man-hours and expenditures were totaled, it came to thousands of credits wasted in wartime.
I assume Kalor won't be working for Personnel Division anymore.
I'm not privy to his employment status, but I suspect you're right. I still can't believe this day has finally come. The suspicion, the reservations, the endless questions. They've been a part of my life for so long. But no more. I am a citizen of the Galactic Republic.
It's great to see this happening for you.
Thank you so much. I've never felt prouder to be serving the Republic. Let's return to the front lines. I want to go back to doing my part.
Time to get this ship moving.
I'll prepare my equipment, sir. I've been wondering what life will be like when the war finally ends. I've always known that there will be peace eventually, but...
People in the Empire even know the meaning of the word?
Absolutely. In the Empire, peace comes when all enemies are destroyed. All that truly matters is that I have you with me, whatever the future brings. I want you to be a part of my life, no matter what may come. I want to be with you forever.
Marry me, Alara. We'll face the future together.
You mean it? Oh, yes! We'll have to do things properly someday. A military ceremony, dress uniforms. Do you think General Garza would officiate?
I'm sure we could convince her.
I hope so. She has such an authoritative speaking voice. For now, just know I'm yours. Now and forever.
The most beautiful girl in the galaxy. All to myself.
I love you. So, not to rush anything, but would you be at all interested in raising children someday? I'm not suggesting any time in the immediate future, of course, but someday, perhaps?
I'd love to raise kids someday, Alara.
I think I would, too. It would mean a lot to me to have a real family again someday. I think I would be an excellent mother to our children. I could teach them all about medicine, biology, legal terminology. I could even teach them about their brave and noble father who took the stuffy Imperial no one liked and made her the happiest woman in the galaxy.
Any kids you raised would be smart and brave and have a good conscience.
I don't think I'd be the only good influence on them. Like I said, I don't think it's a step we should take anytime soon, but someday.